All right, so hello everyone. My name is Irina Antonets, and I'm gonna shortly introduce myself and my program. I will share the screen. Can you see Lost in Nature exhibition?
Yes.
So here's the video. This is one of the paintings and kind of in my style. Then that was just some description of the exhibition that I made. And that's why I said, like, after this exhibition, I realized I wanted to grow as an artist. And so we have a studio that we share, and everyone has their own space. This is one of the photos from my space. Basically you bring there everything you need, your materials, and you can stay there as long as you want, work on your projects, experiment. This is the photo from one of our open exhibitions, kind of open studio it was called, where each of us was sharing the projects that we made. These are some of the experimental things that I'm doing. Like, I'm researching microorganisms, fungi, and my art is more related to bio art. That's the field that I chose. All of us, we have very different topics, like feminism, social problems, and we have performance artists, we have the artists that are working with clay. My field is more of this type of art related to nature and microorganisms. I also do animations, which I am developing right now also. For example, this. So I'm creating artworks and then doing various movements with them. So these are some of the last.
There is no beginning. There is no end. Everything is changing. Everything is growing. Everything is breathing.
Yes. And this is in the studio. That's how we work. So we have, I think, like, four classes, but I would say that our work is really based on own research as well. It's important to spend time yourself doing your own research, because the practice is really research-based. The professors are also always available for individual classes if you need, like, to discuss your projects. We also have, like, art-related classes, video creation-related classes, like, kind of philosophical classes, very interesting. And overall, I'm enjoying this studying, and all of the classes are useful for me. I also like that we have quite a lot of freedom in expression, in what we are doing, in choosing the topics. I just wanted to say also that we have great social life. These are just some of the pictures from our events. We have, like, annual topics where you can participate, interact. I mean, if you love social life, then Prague College is a great place to be. Yes. Yeah, overall, I also love that we have small classes. You have a lot of individual attention. And also, I love the exchange between all of us because all of the people in the class are from different countries, different cultures. And I love to learn from them and hear the feedback from people that had absolutely different experience in life, in culture, in art. I think this is really important experience for anyone who wants to develop in art or in design, and like really to hear people from other cultures. And I love the artist talks. So almost each 2 weeks, I would say, we have like invited artists and or designers, and it's always very interesting to listen to them. These are free lectures that you can visit. Yes, I think I'm done, and I will answer more in the questions.
Great. Well, thank you. My name is Sky. I am studying the Masters of Future Design, and I will tell you a bit about my program and share with you a little presentation I made for this. Okay, I hope you can see this. I should say I'm a future designer. So about the program, the Masters of Future Design is for us. I started only, like I'm only in the first year. I started in September. It's been 100% online. I haven't seen most of my classmates. I saw two of them all the way in the beginning before the classes even started. But we are 8 students from all over the world, which means we have someone from America, someone from India, and people from Europe, like literally everywhere over the world, which is kind of funny when we have classes. They are always at 5 in the evening for Europe time or like for Prague time because, well, so it's a daytime for everyone. Everyone has a bachelor background, but they vary. Like I'm in class with really different backgrounds of people, but most of them are pretty creative already. This study is very independent. Like you work on projects and you have to kind of come up with your own process with what you want to do and how you're going to do it. So it's takes a bit of planning and a lot of communication with your teachers basically. And I spend about 6 hours in class, and next to that I also spend time of course on my project, because the classes are mostly just consultation, which means that the working on the project actually happens throughout the week. So I spend like usually like 15 hours or so on school in a week, and sometimes more, sometimes less. But it's very open to how deep you want to go with the research, because if you're really enjoying something, then you can go on and like make it a full-time study out of it. So I'll tell you a bit about the courses I had. I had 2 in the last semester, which were innovation by design and design research methods. And I have 2 now in this semester, which are future design practice and critical thinking and theoretical context. So I'll tell you a little bit about each of them. So innovation by design is about different approaches of design. So it's not like it's very common to design for a person, for a group of people or a target audience, which are usually all like humans, but it can go beyond that. So you could be thinking of designing for, I don't know, animals, the planet, or even like designing for tools that are not here yet, but might be in the future. So it's really innovative. And well, we had some lectures about it, we had workshops, and a lot of consultation. And well, since we are online, workshops are online, and we use Miro for that, so we can all kind of like put our inputs on boards and go through it with the classes. This kind of my project. I started with the politics of design because I was inspired by my classmates and how people from different cultures look differently at design and design choices. And I thought like, oh, I want to do something that will give an immersive experience of this, like of a culture. And I started out with thinking like, oh, that could be VR, but I already soon realized that VR is something we already have here. It's not very far going. So I came up with this idea that actually, if you want something else that's very immersive, you could be thinking about drugs. And so I came up with the idea of a pill that would give you a cultural experience. And then I thought like, how am I going to, because I'm not going to make any pills, of course, but how would this concept be perceived by people? And so that made me think of Elon Musk and his brain implant chip that can like do something with your eyes and all these really futuristic ideas. So I kind of made a fake news website where I had Elon Musk, a deep fake of Elon Musk giving a presentation about this topic. This is the first time I got to work with AI, which really inspired me for the things I did later in this semester. So that's about innovation by design. And I had also design research methods, which was really human-centered design. So kind of the opposite, really on like how to work with people and yeah, trying out different research methods. And we did that in teams. So I was working with a classmate from Saudi Arabia, and we kind of went into this research project together, and we were inspired by also again, like differences between culture and how, like what stands out for both of us. And we interviewed Syrian people. We kind of took Syrians because he was from Syria as well. And I'm from the Netherlands. So there's big cultural difference, and we kind of went this whole project finding out what do we have in common, what's something that interesting for both cultures. And so we came up with this app about superstition, and here you can see like basically our whole research with also in Miro with all these people we've interviewed and collected data of. Well, this is the final product we made. So we made basically an application about superstitions where you can do all kinds of stuff. And these classes were mostly lectures and also consultations when we were further in the project. So this semester we are working, we are doing a design practice, which is really like we were asked to think about what you want to do in the future and what do you need to get there. So like developing skills and networking and creating a portfolio. Yeah, this is just very into detail, but yeah, I started this project about artificial intelligence because I really like to work with new technologies. And I think when you like these topics, you're really at the right place at Future Design. And so I kind of started learning coding, but this is all, I did research into AI in the game industry and 3D art and how to make art using artificial intelligence and computer programs basically. But it's very free, like I went all the way into this topic, but I have a classmate who is designing life in space. I have a classmate who's making a augmented reality layer over Prague and all these kinds of, I think they're real cool projects. So this is something I'm working on now. Like this is basically my research, what I'm going to present in the end. So I had this really big research. I didn't have anything specific coming out, but a lot of like loose ends. So I kind of combined them, all these loose ends into Instagram page, which I'm working on now and hoping to present soon to my teacher and classmates. And the last course is like critical thinking and theory, which is a lot of like philosophical ideas. These are mainly classes where we listen to the teacher who is just giving us a lectures and then we have discussion about it. And we're just supposed to like show how we apply these things in our projects. And some of the topics are like, for example, what are objects? What are different perspectives on planet Earth? And a lot about science and what to trust, what not, and yeah, just a lot of talking basically. So last part of my showing on my presentation is to tell, like, just like Irina, we have also a lot of freedom. You get to choose your topics yourself. You have to also, like, research yourself and set up what you want to accomplish also yourself. There's a lot of time, like a lot of classes where you can just discuss with your teacher or with your classmates, get feedback on what you're doing, like have them think with you and these kind of things. And they're really encouraging you to think beyond what we do now. So really, like, futuristic, not too extreme. There should also be some base. Some classes are a bit less than others in that, but yeah, the teachers are really nice. And of course, I get really inspired by all these people from all over the world. And next to that, what I said before, like, you can kind of choose how much time and effort you want to put into the research. So if you have a side job or a full-time job, you can actually do this kind of thing still. It will be maybe less of the time you can put into it. But yeah, if you have a lot of time, you can make it really, like, expand it to what you want to accomplish. And that's really nice, I think. So yeah, that's basically all I wanted to say about the future design part of the master's. But yeah, I see also a lot of similarities between fine arts and future design. Like, I think basically the master's means is very free and you get a lot of opportunities to go in the direction that you want and to, like, shape it towards your own needs, basically.
Yeah, but you need to be, like, ready to work on your own a lot. And
it's very, like, independent.
Yeah. To have, like, your initiative, because it's not bachelor's anymore.
Yeah, I think the best is if you step into this master's with some sort of goal. Like, you can always, like, change your path throughout. But if you have something in mind, because I really thought I wanted to do more with these new technologies, and that keeps kind of a baseline for me. Did you also have a certain direction you already wanted when you started, for example, future design? Or, well, you said, yeah, like, with fine arts, you really knew what you wanted, but when you started future design?
Yeah, I was, like, more into ecological projects and so on, and we were designing, like, some stuff for the planet and one, like, some also AI projects, but, like, more related to how to save the planet, how to teach people to be more ecologically respectful. But then, like, on at the second year of future design, I started going into microorganisms, so bioart. It's all connected, because design is really connected to art. At least what I learned from future design is that, like, everything is connected. Designer is not a narrow field designer. Designer is everything. It's a doctor, it's a researcher, it's a, I don't know, it's a teacher, it's everything. So it's kind of mixed now.
Yeah, definitely, I agree. So I think we are kind of at the point where we need to, or where we could answer some questions if there are any. How much time do you spend in a week for your studies?
I think it's pretty same. Like, I decide myself. I mean, of course, there are classes and they would take, like, maybe 7 hours. I don't know. 10 hours, but then you might work every day on your own. Like, I spend lots of time in studio sometimes. Sometimes it's closer to some presentations that I spend even more time. And yeah, but you can schedule your own, like, work, really. Sometimes I can work all day and then, like, rest. It depends, really.
Yeah, that's exactly the same for me. Like, I sometimes spend a whole day just going deep into this research or designing, but then another day I could just, like, plan it differently. Yeah. And do you have a studio to work in? Do you work there with, like, people from different, also from, like, all over the world?
Yes, well, for us also it was different, quite different, I think, because it was COVID time, and we had to, like, for artists it was crazy, of course, but still, like, we had studio available, but we had to schedule it. There were some times when we were away, able to actually work all together, and it was really cool because, like, we could give each other feedback on our projects. So
yeah, that's really nice. I wonder though, if you're like, if you had also any online classmates, because for me it's so different, like I had everything online.
Absolutely, like it was quite different. Yeah, like we also had like people from America, and if I'm not mistaken, from Egypt, from Singapore, and it was kind of crazy because you had to fit into this time frames. But it is also a nice experience still, and I would say like Zoom classes are good because you really save your time. And you don't spend time like going to the school, going back, you're doing everything from home.
That's true.
Yeah. So maybe like a mix of Zoom classes and real classes would be a perfect thing.
Yeah, I think that would be really cool. Yeah.
Yeah. And maybe I would add this for this question about what resources are there available? I would mention our library. It's really great. Like if you use it, there are many, many things that are free to use and to do your research if you have time for that. Tisside Library.
Yeah. Yeah. I also would mention the resources at school. I know there's this guy in the basement of Prague College who has like any camera or microphone or anything that if you're here in Prague that you could borrow. And it's really nice because actually for this deep faking, I found out that it would be best for me to like record someone on the green screen, and I could do all of that at school, which was really nice. And I even got help from this guy to set it all up. So that's actually also a good one.
Yes. Yeah, and about the location, we have for now two places. So for designers, I would say it's Bishop's Court, right? Which is more like in the center of Prague. And then there is Pragovka, which is more for artists. And then it will be also, if I'm not mistaken, for business departments as well. But it's more of an art district.
Studio. Yeah, I have been at Bishop's Court like this one time before the class started, and for the rest I know the like the main place, but yeah, it seems like it would like, if well, for me it was for a long time that only me and one other were in Prague, so we didn't really go there, but I think if you would be here with classmates, it's nice to like have a place to go to. Yeah,
it's nice really, because also there are computers, there's some books, tables, so you can just, I used to work there all day, like when COVID just started last year and I was doing my final project, I spent like literally days at Bishop's Court. I felt like more comfortable to work there. It was like kind of office for me. And you can come anytime. There is some food like that you can keep. I think there is a fridge or like microwave or something like that. You can use. I think we answered quite a lot.
I think so too. And if there's no more questions, then I don't really know what else to tell them. I see no more questions, so we can finish.
All right. So, hope it was helpful.
Yeah, I want to thank everyone for watching, and maybe see you someday.
Yes, we are always available, right? If there are any questions later.
Definitely. All right.
Bye. Bye.